Good evening. Now, responsible, grown-up, mature people are supposed to greet each other like this. Hi, Jeremy, how are you?
Mike, how are you? How's your work?
Oh, work's going very well. How are you? How's everything with you? How's your life? Are you succeeding?
Difficult at times, but not too bad.
Oh, that's good. I don't really mean what I'm saying to you anyway.
No,
but
neither.
Anyway,
neither. Yeah.
But we don't do the guys. G'day, buddy! Because it's nice to see each other. It's nice to see on the Tuesday night. Nice to see you too as well. We've been battling away hammer and bloody tongs this week to make 22 minutes of television that we call Havoc Luxury Suites and Conference Facility out on the ads, and there's your half hour.
And this week we've got extra special, super jammy, wonderful, fantastic television for you, including a new craze, new art, and an old interview
that we brought out from the Miami files. Won't you join us? My name's Mike Havoc.
And I'm the Newsboy.
And here's half an hour of
television made right here in New Zealand.
You might have noticed the telltale signs. Missing wheels on your chair at work, bent photocopiers and formica peeling off the edge of your desk. It's not necessarily because most office furniture is cheap mass-produced shit that doesn't last more than a couple of weeks. Chances are it's been dropping in out at the local skate ghetto, where it gets ridden around on by the new urban warriors. A devil-may-care breed of double extreme hardcore thrill-seekers, cool kids who don't recognise pain. Just the need for speed, vertical takeoff and a speedy whiteboard on wheels.
We track down the perpetrators after a tip-off from lazy old hump extreme sports Delana Cocroft. The location? Victoria Park, central Auckland.
So office furniture, that's the new underground extreme craze. You're taking it to the parks?
Yeah, we've been doing it for a little while. It's since it's been getting unwanted media attention, it's become a little bit more sort of popular. But
surely if you're going to ride a fax machine down a bowl, people are going to take notice.
I guess so, but it's just like hardcore, you know? Like doing it, doesn't matter what it is, office furniture, bedroom furniture, just fucking grind it, you know?
Extreme and over the edge, all right, but it gets crazier.
The more observant of you will have noticed TV1's April Aramia had trouble with the height adjuster on her chair this week. TVNZ has suggested a simple explanation. These adrenaline junkies are upping the ante and breaking into Crown Node companies, or COCs, and stealing furniture right from out under presenters' plump little sporty asses. Or so it seems from this security camera footage.
There's been speculation that maybe you or one of your group was behind the April Aramia's chair being stolen 5 nights in a row.
You guys, you know anything about April Aramia's chair?
And then they bailed right after that last question, leaving us wondering where they'd turn up next. In Parry Max for vandalism? In Sports Illustrated with a worldwide Nike sponsorship? Or maybe just hospital? It's anyone's guess. But until we start taking kids seriously and having focus groups, giving them their own channel, looking after specific demographics, and handing out goodies for free on the side of the road, this blatant disregard for the rules is going to continue. Anything with wheels is a target. So ask yourself, how long till every skate park in New Zealand is rattling with the sound of hotted up faxes and those special bins that they put in ladies' toilets? Speculate all you like. Conspiracy theorists on the internet have said that perhaps Eric, my wife, was on that Treasure Island thing. Watson might have something to do with it. He's a multi-millionaire because of office furniture and stationery. But the kids of today are nowhere near stationery. They're on the go and they're on office furniture. So if you're an office manager, you might want to check the trucks on your tea trolley or on your office chair before it gets serious air. Sitting on a pedestal, but be specific. I'm not terrific, just a manifest I'm looking at.